Welcome to Justin's Gaming Corner. Now, you know sometimes you play a game and you love it, and then you play a sequel and you're like, oh, this just doesn't compare. This is not as good. This stinks. Well, I'm here to tell you today that Little Nightmares 2, well, it doesn't fall in line with that at all. As a matter of fact, Little Nightmares 2 is bigger, better, in every way possible. A sequel that is infinitely better than the original in every way. What you would want out of a sequel, this game delivers. But let's dive in to see why this game is so good. So in Little Nightmares 2, you play as the character named Mono. You sort of just appear out of nowhere from a TV, and it's like, okay, what is going on? And that is where the game really just sort of puts you, and you take off in this dark and dank woods, forest. You don't know what's happening. You just know it's creepy, there's dead bodies everywhere, but soon enough you do run into Six, a character from the original game. Somehow she's been captured, and she's there, and you rescue her. And thus begins your journey to the Pale City. Your escape, or hopeful escape. Now, Little Nightmares 2 is a game that continues in the tradition of the first. It is a side-scrolling platform puzzle game. But that being said, there are some combat moments added into this, more so than in the first, and there is much more elaborate puzzles, and there's much more set pieces, and there's much more atmosphere. Yes, I told you this is a sequel that pretty much defines what a sequel should be in every way possible, and again, I stand by that. Little Nightmares 2 is exceptionally good and exceptionally awesome and exceptionally creepy. Now, for a game that has you playing as like little kids in a city and weird stuff happening, you'd think, how can this game really offer up creepiness, right? I mean, how? How is it fathomable? But when you think about it and break it down, it all comes down to sound, atmosphere, and style. I mean, really. Of course, then there's also throwing you in situations where you want to run and hide and just get away from the things chasing you because they look horrible and monstrous, but it's all those things combined that really make the game what it is and deliver it in a way that makes you feel tension, makes you feel mystery, makes you wonder what's around the next corner. And let me tell you, the whole game keeps that element alive the entire game. It's just almost a non-stop assault on your senses in that regard. Now, the game will probably last you about 6 hours, which is about double of what the original game was if you don't include the DLC. If you played the main game and the DLC in the first, I would say it's probably about that length as far as the whole title goes. If you had to ask me, Justin, what do you love about Little Nightmares 2? Okay, it's simple. Almost everything. The sound design, the graphics, the atmosphere, the puzzles. I feel that this game is constantly changing everything you're doing. The variety of what you're going through, and that is through sound effects, through audio, through levels, through objectives. There's never a dull moment, and that is a crowning achievement. Add on to the fact I never had any glitches, I never had any issues as far as crashing. Honestly, as far as everything goes, at least on the PlayStation 4 via PlayStation 5, I had an extremely smooth experience, and this isn't really even a thing I don't like. I actually like this, but if I had to really think of something that some people might not like about this game, and I'm just going to go from that perspective since I don't want to say, oh, there's nothing wrong with this game, but I would actually say it's going to be the story elements, because like the first, the story is very basic, but very cryptic. Things are not spelled out for you. So those that like Dark Souls and other things with trying to dig deep into the lore of what things mean and all that will really find a lot to like here. And until the next time, thank you guys for checking it out. I really liked Little Nightmares 2, if you couldn't tell. I just want to say thank you to the devs and the development team and the publishers and all that for just pulling out a really awesome game that will stick with me for a long time. And I can already tell you right now, no, there is no denying this game will be in a top 10 list for me for 2021. There's no doubts. I already know. It's just, I wanted to play it the minute I finished it. And that is always a good sign for me. But until the next video, thank you for checking out Justin's Gaming Corner. Until the next time.